Hello everyone and welcome to another episode of Let's Design City Skylines. My name is Rick Duster and we're back at Cedar Valley where we're taking a look at our main park, our main very green attraction space thing. Very, very accurate in terms of the words that I'm using right here in the middle of the city. So yeah, welcome back. It's there's a lot that needs to be done in the city and I think we should get started right away. And I wanted to begin by taking a look at our vitals, if you will, just to check on how things are progressing. I'm getting this weird bug every time. I think I changed the mode. I think it's just an issue with the sprites. I don't know. But it's really not that big of a deal, I don't think. So in terms of garbage, I think we're doing okay. In terms of education, not so well. Elementary school, we only have two tiny elementary schools. Maybe it would not be a bad idea to have another one over in this corner. And let's take a look about high school. High school, we only have two. We have this modern one right here and non-modern one over there. So maybe we could have another high school over here. And of course, university will only have one for the time being. So we should probably work on this as well, because in the last episode, if you remember correctly, we made this avenue go sort of underneath the university. So that's part of this episode I wanted to dedicate to this area of town. Maybe we can extend some of these avenues and start, you know, wrapping this sort of peninsula that we have here. So I guess in terms of schools, let's start with elementary school. Let's just plop that one over here. And that will be great, hopefully. Can we not fit it on these spots? We definitely need to do something about these spots because they're a little bit odd, but I think we could potentially do something cool about it, like maybe... I guess we can zone them too, but let's see. How would this look if it was zoned like that? Kind of overlaps this. I'm not sure if anything will grow. Let's just speed things up. Of course, the demand right now is for commercial for the most part, so I'm not entirely sure really what's when this is going to grow. But for the time being, I think that does it. So elementary school there, fantastic. Let's go back to... high school, and I think we needed a high school somewhere on this corner, so let's go ahead and put that in. Should be enough. We can actually grab the dirt path and just sort of surround the elementary school and then basically sell the rest, so I'm not too worried about that. I was also thinking of increasing the density of many of these zoned areas, specifically the ones for commercial. So I guess that's sort of doing it. There we go. I think it's a little bit laggy. There we go. Cool. Yeah, we're going to start increasing the density of all these things. Another thing that I notice is that if we go to... Well, let's continue. Happiness. People around here don't seem to be very happy, and I think it's mainly because of the noise. So what I was thinking is maybe behind this train station we can have a few parks, because that will increase the land value as well as overall happiness. What's going on here? High density, blah, blah, blah. Okay. Let's take a look at health. Health, yeah, we're not doing great. We have two tiny clinics. I mean, we have a big medical clinic. Yeah, we definitely need a big hospital. So let's go ahead and do that right now. Let's put down a big hospital. I think this would be a good location. Let's see. Actually, maybe somewhere right here in the middle would be a better location for our hospital. Because, yeah, this will pretty much cover that whole area. So let's just go ahead and put it right there. I think this is a good location for our hospital. And also kind of like opens up to this Central Park thing, so that helps quite a bit. Let's see, what else do we need? Let's take a look at, what are these? These are like the different zones. Wind, I don't think we care about that. So in terms of health, this hopefully will start taking care of itself. Death care, I think we're doing pretty good. Emptying finish. Oh, wow, I forgot to turn that on. So this one is almost full. We might need a few more incinerators, to be completely honest with you. So let's go ahead and put that down real quick. And maybe we can integrate them just here on this squares that we have. And honestly, might as well just fill it with trees. I think that will look pretty good. There we go. These are basically the lungs of our city. Just put down a ton of trees. Create some sort of like thick dense area. Very nature-y. Okay, we have another spot over here. I might as well just fill all these holes with trees. That came out of my mouth, and I was coming out of my mouth. I was like, this doesn't sound right, but it is what it is. I mean, we're filling holes, even though they're metaphorical holes, with trees. So make all these very dense. Hopefully it will look nice. Let's see, I think we can squeeze in a tree over there. Let's do the same over here. There we go. Yeah, things don't seem to be growing in here. So we might as well fill it with trees. For the time being, eventually we're probably going to zone them. But it's good to have green spaces throughout the city in general. Just wish that people would consider this actual parks. Do we have any smaller parks actually? Like one by ones? One by one. There we go. We can have a swim park here. Oh, that totally works. So let's mix them up a little bit. Maybe we need more of these one-by-one parks. Let's take a look at them real quick. Oh yeah, we have the swings here. Perfect. All right, that doesn't look too repetitive. And we have a ton of trees in here as well. We might as well mix it with other types of trees. Like maybe we can have some palm trees for change. I don't know. Just to add a bit more of a variant. Kind of want to put them on their own. There we go. Something like that. And then we can just fill the rest with trees as well. There we go. Perfect. So that actually makes a huge difference, in my opinion. So might as well do it everywhere else. Not sure if I'm going to put swings in all these tiny barks. But we're definitely going to fill it with trees. And it's going to look fantastic. So maybe here we can actually do some swings. Get a few palm trees as well. Just a little bit randomly. Let's go with a one by one swing over there. I think that's it. There we go. Cool. Oh, we have two more spots over here. Two more of these triangles. So this is the thing with diagonals is that it creates this odd spots where usually in real life you can get actual houses in the shape of a triangle, but in this game or any other game that's similar to this, you just can't grow anything like that. All right, so we have a few those. Let's put down some swings over here as well, because why not? And that pretty much does it, at least for this part. It actually looks really, really nice. Maybe we should try the same thing over here. Tons and tons of trees. Since we're gonna be so close to the soccer field, we might not do the swings in here. Can also do tons of trees in there as well. Let's put down some palm trees for good measure. Actually, now that I think about it, if we're going to do that, we should probably get some palm trees here as well. Just randomly at different corners. We can even use this the bushes to position them. It's almost like they're wrapping the palm trees, which makes it all look even nicer. Also, I don't want to do it everywhere, just in a few select places. And by the way, this is probably the last pre-recorded episode, so hooray. Hopefully I can catch up by the time I'm recording this on the night of Halloween. Ooh, spooky. Yeah, this episode should be coming out at some point in early January. I don't have the exact date with me. But most of the previous videos, actually all of the previous videos, were scheduled that way, so fun times. Pre-recording a ton of episodes, even though they are once a week. I'm not keeping my schedule as it used to be. Still pretty hard work, but hopefully you guys are enjoying this. I guess if you're watching this, you are, because you keep coming back. And if you're new, welcome to my channel. Okay, that does it for now. Maybe slow down the simulation. I didn't know I was going all full speed. In fact, maybe I can even pause the game for the time being. That actually looks great. It totally adds a little bit of character to our Central Park here. So let's put down some more of these vines. Trust me, it's not going to be all plopping down trees. Hopefully I sped this up. And as I was editing this video, so I guess it did zone better on this side of the city, but it's okay. I mean, we don't have to have the mirrored corners of the city anyways. So let's have some swings over there. We can have some swings over here. Actually, we should probably have swings over there and clear this. And just surround this corner with trees. Same over here. Like so. Let's see, are we missing anything? I think we're in good shape. We're definitely in good shape. So, okay, we needed to put down a few more parks here. So maybe let's dezone this whole area. And we're gonna create some, well, first of all, we can put down some parking lots, which also act as parks. So industrial decor, what about this? We can do the walkway too. And then what do we do in the middle, though? I guess we just fill it with trees, because why not, right? Let's get some... I guess we can do a bike path over here. So we haven't done that in a while. So we can do the bike path there. And I guess we could just have a few gravel roads. Same over here, if possible. There we go. And the rest is just going to be filled with trees. Wow, those are huge trees, but I guess they work. Actually, we can do some palm trees, like a line of palm trees. Why not? There we go. It's a cool looking train station, if I'm honest. Pretty happy how that's looking. So we have an actual park with parking lots, which is kind of what I wanted. Unfortunately, this houses will still suffer the noise, but it's not going to be too bad. In fact, we can replicate the exact same design over here. Let's go ahead and do that, because that's going to look fan-freaking-tastic. So walkway. Get the dirt. Also, I know this bike lane doesn't really go anywhere, but eventually, some of these avenues will have their own bike lanes, so I don't know. It works for now. Let's dezone that. Let's put down some of these pines over here in the middle. And let's do our row of palm trees right in between the bike path. And I guess it didn't like it. There we go. Fantastic. have a big tree over here and another one over there, just for good measure. I was also thinking about maybe doing something underneath the, well, there's a house there, so not a whole lot I can do about that. It actually looks kind of cute. I was thinking of converting some of these, you know, this part of the... Whoa, what just happened there? Hang on, I need to dezone this first, because otherwise it's just going to be pretty crazy. And we're definitely going to get weird results. Let me just speed things up a bit. Okay, so that is dezoned. I want to keep that tiny house there. So what I was saying is maybe you can get gravel underneath the... the train tracks. So we're going to do three. Let's see how that looks. That actually looks a little bit more realistic, to be honest. So we can add some bushes around. I mean, we already kind of have some bushes around the tracks. But this actually, like, I don't know. It's just an accent color. I think it totally does it for me. So I'm gonna go ahead and do it. Usually grass shouldn't grow underneath the railroad tracks. That's just a fact. So hopefully we can get a decent looking under part of this. I mean, look at that. Isn't that pretty? I think that's pretty gorgeous. Let's see, do we want to curve this part around? Maybe not. Let's get the inner part going like that. Oh, you know what? Maybe the middle part could be a bike path. Yes. This is fantastic. This is going to be great. And we're just going to dezone all of this. And we're going to rezone it high density all the way to there. Perfect. Let's grab the bike path once again. And we should be almost done with this. Well, I mean, we have the bike path here. So I'm guessing people will just go across this thing. Is it the same over here? Yep. Cool. This is looking pretty good. I'm feeling good about this. So, wait, we also need to like dezone this. Turn it into high density. Same with this, high density. Same with this, high density. And right here, we should also make this high density. So speed things up a bit. Let's take a look at, let's see, what else are we missing here? Pollution, I think we're good in terms of pollution. What about air pollution, fire safety? Oh yeah, fire safety. We don't have many fire stations in the area where fire safety is actually a problem. So, I mean, it happens in the city too, but maybe we should have a fire station somewhere around here. It wouldn't be the worst idea in the world, so maybe we can just put down one over there. Does the power reach? It does reach. That's perfect. And we also have a lot of demand for industrial, so maybe we should zone a little bit more industrial. Maybe just complete that. See if we can get... I don't know, something like that. I don't wanna zone absolutely everything, just a few tiles. And start slowly integrating this area of the industrial park together with this. At the same time, I was thinking that we maybe need another train station, an elevated train station here for workers to actually commute on the by train. But we'll get to that eventually. I don't think we're going to be focusing on that right now. We do have a lot of demand for commercial. Let's take a look at the zones again. I think we're missing some commercial over here, so maybe we should do that. Maybe right behind the high school will be a good idea. Maybe this whole segment will be... Wow, I need to really dezone all of this. I think we even got a house here. There we go. That's crazy. I think it's because we were using the overlap instead of the collide. That's why I wasn't clearing the zoning underneath. But hopefully that will take care of that. So we have some commercial here. And I guess the back of this will also be residential. Fantastic. Medical clinic. Okay, cool. So... Let's do some road work. Let's do some road work because, well, it's needed. Road work is needed. So I think I'm just going to go free mode fall. No, I'm not sure what I mean, actually, so I can't really explain it to you, even if I wanted to. Even if I could, not if I wanted to. I definitely want to, but... So I think this avenue will sort of hug the coast right here. And hopefully it will look good. Maybe we can go like this. So right about here, let's see, where are we? This looks nice. I just think that we should probably continue straight for a little bit. Just to give us some structure. Maybe this, I want this to be some sort of like hotel friendly area of sorts. I don't know. We'll get to that, but at least this gives us a little bit of structure, and now we can potentially complete our grid this way. Let's do the same over here. There we go. Let's grab the six-lane avenue and bring it all the way to here and here. Perfect. That's pretty good. So we have our sunken underground avenue thing here. So what we need to do is turn on this. There we go. Grab the one-way tool. And I think we need to go... Was it... I think it was 20. Now I'm not sure. Yeah, it was 20 units. Okay, cool. So 20 units. Perfect. And... The next one is going to be the medium density four lane avenue. There we go. I think we can just go in all the way. Is it straight? I think it's straight. It's just the camera angle is a little bit tricky sometimes, but it's definitely straight. So let's grab this avenue and just extend it all the way over there and over there. Fantastic. Now, I want to keep measuring this towards this area so that we can get the other street following in this direction. There we go. Perfect. It's actually going to go the other way. Man, the perspective really lies to you when you're trying to align this road. So I'm guessing maybe we can go another... Hang on, if we go to 20 units, this is where the 6-lane avenue is should connect if we're following the same style. And this is where the underground started. So I'm not sure if you want to bring it back up against this road or against this road. I think against this road should be okay. And if that doesn't make any sense, what I just said, trust me, I don't know what I mean. Okay, so page down. There we go. And I'm not sure how deep I was. That looks deep enough. I don't want it to go like crazy underground, you know? So let's grab the one-way road. I need to fix this curve in order to connect this road. And well, let's see, what about here? Can we go in? Okay, no, we cannot. That's cool. Okay, so let's fix the arrows first, because that's going to be the arrows, the direction of the road. So this one is going the right way. This one, however, needs to go the other way. And if that one is going up, this one should go down. Like so. Perfect. There we go. All right. So let's just extend this all the way to here. And then fix the orientation of it. Fantastic. Love it. Okay, so let's work on the university. I mean, wait, no, let's just extend this 6-lane avenue now that I'm at it. Cool. So let's work on the university now. I'm thinking of having the sort of the same pattern here, having like a lush park right in front of it. So, but in this case, I think I want something a little bit more symmetric. Maybe we can even use cement just for a change. So let's go ahead and bring that up. Let's see, can I get... Oh, I can't plop there. Well, I guess I can use overlap. Because why not? We can do something like this. Cool. All right. So we have that going. And here we can just have a diagonal. Same over here. Cool. So that's symmetric-ish. A little bit. And let's grab the hedges. Where do I have them? They're somewhere around here. Oh, they're actually in the parks menu. Let's look for it. Here we go. So we have this hedge, and we have this hedge, which is darker. Let's plop both of them. I kind of like the lighter one, so let's go with that. All right, so that's our big park in front of the university. I think it looks pretty good. There's a ton of seabirds just flying around this area of the city, but yeah, still looking pretty good. I mean, if you look at it from this angle, I mean, that's a hell of an entrance to the university, if you ask me. So, yeah, ask me. So, let's just finish this real quick. Let's continue the development towards this area. We're not going to do crazy things, but I do want to get some parking lots in here. And maybe the two-story parking lots will be a good thing, a good addition to this. Simply because I expect a little bit of traffic over here. So maybe we can have a bit of a loop with potentially with bike lanes, if possible. Can we get bike lanes here? Maybe not. Let's just go, let's just connect it like this. That should be okay. Let's grab the cement. There we go. Just trying to mix it up like that. Fantastic. Let's grab one of the pine trees. Just put it there as well. And now we can potentially, if all goes well, we can get... Wait, why is... Oh, I made mistakes. I made mistakes. We need to go into collide. Otherwise, we can't zone. There we go. Okay, perfect. So now that we have that, we can fit no more than two, really? What if we do it like that? I guess that works. Okay, cool. So we're just gonna have a row of trees right here in the middle as separation. Now, I don't think we need a bike lane for this, so we might as well just upgrade this to a tree lined. And we can just fill the rest with trees as well. Pines should be sufficient for now. So this is a big campus, but I think I like how it's looking. Maybe this should be dirt paths. I think the hint of orange will go a long ways here. Yep, definitely. It just adds a little bit more pizzazz to the construction, so I like it. I'm gonna keep that. But yeah, I mean, this is our university. It's actually looking pretty good. So far, so good. So, okay, let's continue this avenue over here real quick. And hopefully we can get a straight line into the avenue. Fantastic. Okay, so the last thing before I go, and before, I mean, all this will need to be taken care of in the next episode. Before I go, I wanted to do one last thing. Right now we have the high school in the middle of the way of the train station, so we might want to change the location of such. And maybe probably, I don't know, somewhere here will be nice. Maybe against that. That street, and we can have the gravel road just to wrap it up. And now that we clear that, we can certainly disown all this. There we go. Hopefully it will take care of the cleaning for me. There we go. Fantastic. Let's go back to normal speed. Let's grab rail, because what we want to do is get a train station right behind the university. So we're gonna put it right there, and we're gonna scroll all the way to that part, and now somehow we need to connect. I need to get rid of that first. Connect these two together. Maybe we should also clear this, because we're gonna need to extend this avenue a little bit further. So we might as well do it like that. I guess this avenue will need to be rebuilt eventually. I'm okay with that. Just a few dead ends here and there. It's not too bad. Let's clear that. And let's grab the rail right about, I think we can just start curving it somewhere around here. Actually, right in the middle of this is, are we gonna have any type of road? No, we're in the middle of the block, so that should be clean. Okay, So we have a pillars issue here. Ooh, this is new. What is this? Illumination, what is this? Hold on 1 second. Does that mean that it has lights? Concrete. Oh, this is the modifiers of the thing that I downloaded. So if we go down. Never mind. So let's connect these two together. And we're gonna go overlap. And we're gonna go curve. And that will be that. Do these two curves sort of match? I think they do. Yeah, they do. Perfect. All right, so we have no water because none of these areas of town actually have any water. So let's fix that real quick. Like that. In other words, added, let's just add water to this whole place. There we go. And that's our train station, our very last train station. Let's go full speed and see if people start using it. But as we do that, this would probably be a good time to wrap this episode here because it's been a long one, and I'm sure I made a ton of edits from all the things that I did. So if you enjoy thus far, please do leave this video a rating. That's very much appreciated. And also, please do not forget to subscribe if you haven't already. In the next couple episodes, I'm not sure what I'm going to do because, there's a lot that needs to be done. Hopefully, maybe we can start taking care of this broken grid here. Not sure if we're going to need more bridges or not, but so far it's good. And yeah. A lot of potential in the city. So thank you guys for watching. Hope to see you in the next one.